Right. Okay, here we go. Live.
Okay, here we go.
There's me saying, hey, there we go. Excellent, brilliant. Right. Hello, everyone. I'm Chris from Recombu, and I'm here with the Honor View 20. And we've had this phone for a couple of weeks now. It's just officially launched here in Europe. Over in good old Gay Paris. We should have been at the launch, but crazy week, lots of stuff going on. So I'm here in my glamorous bedsit instead, over in good old London. But we've got the View 20, we've had it for a couple of weeks, so feel free to ask me anything. Our full review has just gone live along with our camera review, and we did an unboxing a good couple of weeks ago as well, so hopefully you've had a chance to see that. Hello everyone, I've got your comments and everything here, so I'm gonna try and get through as many of them as possible. And as I say, anything you want to ask about the View 20 or just life in general, obviously I can offer advice on stuff. Oh, I wouldn't ask me for advice on anything. Hello, Jim. Good to see you. Does anyone have a spare S9 for me to do a review? No, I don't have an S9, actually, unfortunately. Somebody else lives in London. Hello, fellow Londoner. Does the V20 have Gorilla Glass? Is one tough mother? I'm pretty sure it is Gorilla Glass because I've been bashing this thing about for a couple of weeks now. I've literally thrown it in a backpack. I've dropped it a couple of times. Not a single scratch or dent on this thing. If you sort of get it closer, hopefully you can sort of see. Just go check out the review. We've got lots of nice close-ups of all that gorgeous surface and the sexy V insignia type stuff that you get on the back there. Looks very glam. Yeah, it smudges up a storm, of course, like all glass smartphones. Just give it a bit of a buffer now so it looks less crap. But yeah, not a single scratch or scuff on this thing. It's absolutely very impressive indeed. Hello, Black Amex Vlogs. Good to see you. Fortnite on 60fps, amazing. Yeah, I haven't had a chance to test out Fortnite yet, but yes, that was one of the big announcements at the Honor Jobby. The Honor Jobby, very official. The Honor launch today, they announced that partnering with Fortnite to produce 60fps, and also I believe you get some sort of exclusive, was it Honor Guard, something or other, costume. I don't play Fortnite, as if it's not immediately obvious. Is the part of the screen where the punch-hole camera is dimmer than the rest of the screen? No, I haven't noticed that, to be perfectly honest. I'll just punch up a couple of images now so you guys can see that in action. So here we go. Let's just get it to a bright part. There we go. Right on this lady's armpit. As you can see there, it does a really, really good job. It's a tiny little pinhole. You honestly don't even notice it after using it for a day or two. You kind of forget it's even there. So it is a really nice full view effect, as you can see there. Do you still have the Oppo Find X? I want to review that. I do still have the Oppo Find X. I can't give it to you, unfortunately, because it is a loan sample, so it's not technically mine. Tap to wake, no, there's no tap to wake. Somebody else asked that on another video. Sadly, I certainly can't find it if it is buried away in those magic UI features somewhere. But yeah, it's not in any of the standards. It's not in the display settings. You go into the system, stuff there. Nothing. Smart assistants, you do have the usual. You've got the raise to wake and everything. That's all in there as per usual. And the various motion controls as well, so you can flip to mute it, all that sort of stuff. But no tap, unfortunately. I know that a lot of people have been asking Honor to implement that, hopefully one of these days. I'm watching you with great pleasure, says Odegan. Hopefully not too much pleasure. I don't want to ruin your keyboard. How big is this phone? It's a 6.4-incher. Thankfully, because it's got pretty much no bezels, it's no bigger than any other handset I've reviewed recently, to be honest. But yeah, if you want a compact smartphone, this ain't the one. To be perfectly honest, you'd probably be better off with like Xperia XZ2 Compact or something like that. Is the V20 a waterproof gadget? It's not got official IP certification, or at least if it does, they haven't bothered to tell us. But I've given it a good old dowsing. I've taken it out in the rain, it's been absolutely fine there. I haven't fully submerged it is the only thing, because I'm a little bit scared to. But yeah, certainly in terms of just general splash proofness and everything, it seems absolutely fine on all that. Somebody's got an Xperia XZ1, a quality phone. I haven't actually used the XZ1 in a while, unfortunately. XZ2 is still very good as well. Can you make the screen one-handed? Yes, it's got the one-handed mode. Joop, like so. So definitely very, very handy, because you can just about reach up to that notifications bar then. nice and handy. Yeah, I've got tiny little stubby fingers, so I need that kind of shiz in there. It's good to see. Please, for God's sake, price. In the UK, it's £499. From about £33 to £35 a month on contract from the likes of O2. We've had a couple of the dealers get in touch to give us the full contract details. But I can't speak for the rest of the world, but I've only got the UK pricing. Any problems receiving notifications? No problems with the notifications. The only problems I've had with notifications on smartphones recently is with the MIUI 9. Occasionally you'll pull down and you'll go to your Gmail and you'll press to dismiss something and it'll hang around for a few seconds, but I haven't actually had that on the V20, touch wood. So I haven't had that with Magic UI, it's technically called, although it's basically a Motion UI. Any new phones coming out soon? Yes, so many phones. We've reviewed the Honor 10 Lite recently as well, another Honor, two bloody Honor phones. It's only January, people, come on, give me a break. We've got a new Oppo phone coming potentially in next week. We've got a big UK launch, so I'm not sure if they're going to release any handsets there or not, but we'll see. And then it's MWC next month in Barcelona, so we'll have a absolute shag load of phones coming out after that. So if you're in the market for a new phone, maybe hang on a little bit longer. What would you choose, OnePlus 6T or the V20? I've actually fully compared them over on TechSpert, but the V20 for me just about ticks it off. They're about the same sort of price point. I really like the V20's rear mounted camera, 48 megapixel camera. Again, go check out a full review if you haven't seen that yet. Fantastic photo quality across the board. Portrait modes generally works quite well. Video, fantastic. Again, if you dive into the camera, it's basically your typical Honor camera app. Dive into the video, you can see you shoot all the way up to 4K resolution footage. No 60 frames per second option, but at 30 FPS, it's fantastic. Great image stabilization and everything. So I think the camera just about wins it for me because the OnePlus's camera was pretty good, but occasionally you'd kind of get oversaturation, especially in those sort of high contrast shots. It would lose some of its tone and its texture, and the photos wouldn't look amazing. What screen resolution? I hope it's not 1080. It is a full HD plus, 1080 by 2240, something like that. But you know what, to be honest, I have to stick this side by side with like a Quad HD Plus phone to notice any difference in the detail. And even then, with like photos, things like that, it looks great. Your Netflix looks great. Let's just grip that up and just show you a bit of a clip. Any problems or issues that you've noticed? To be honest, I do occasionally with these Honor phones notice a couple of little bits here and there. Sometimes they're a little bit jittery, despite the fact they've got great performance and everything. But on the whole, this one has been absolutely fine. I haven't had any problems whatsoever with it, to be honest. Certainly not that I can recall, anyway. Let's just turn the sound off and boost up the brightness a bit. Boop. There we go, and for some reason it's, why is it not playing in full HD? There we go. Anyway, there you go, as you can see, you can sort of see some of that full view effect. Obviously, it does put the bar across it on the likes of Netflix. Most apps, they do have that bar, so you don't even see the pinhole camera anyway, if that would be an issue. But yeah, no, nice colorful panel and everything, and as I say, the lack of bezels is fantastic. You're not the usual unbox therapy guy. No, he's got a massive beard and he wears a baseball cap. I should start wearing a baseball cap, then I get less comments about being a baldy shit. That would be good. I've just got to throw a link of this into the Twitter. Excuse the momentary pause just onto my personal Twitters. I'm on at CBarUK, by the way, if anyone wants to follow me on Twitter. You probably don't. I just complain about stuff, so I won't even bother, to be honest. OnePlus performed better in battery life test. No, the V20 actually did better in the battery life test for us. 4,000 milliamp cell. Goes a full 2 days unless you're like constantly Skype video call and game and stuff like that. The OnePlus 6T performed well as well. It had that big boost up to a 3,750 milliamp, I believe it was. So it performed a lot better than previous OnePluses, which just about scraped through a day. That one you tend to get about a day and a half, but the V20 is superb when it comes to battery life. Very good stuff. Does it have stereo speaker? No, I don't think for media playback, actually. Let me just play a quick, I believe. Let's just play this. Why not? Get all meta.
Meta.
So if I speak, then blah, 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 blah. Yeah, it's just the bottom speaker. that's producing the media. Oh, let's stop doing that right now, because that's going to be horrendous. That was a bad idea. What are you waiting for, Erdogan? Sorry, did I miss your comment? Hello, please. Hello. Sorry, you type your comment in, please. Sorry, I'm already getting lost in the comments here. How does it compare to the Honor 10? Is it worth the upgrade? Honor 10, so you've obviously got the more premium performance. Kirin 980, fantastic performer. Absolutely brilliant. Battery life, slightly better than the Honor 10 as well. The Honor 10 was pretty good. Make it through a day, day and a half, so no complaints. But it's slightly improved on here. Obviously, you've got the nicer design. You've got the fact that it's that full screen, you know, full front fill-in screen. Design's really nice, and also the camera tech as well as here is a boost up from the Honor 10. The Honor 10 seemed to struggle a bit when it came to like the lower light stuff. It doesn't have the full-on night mode that the Honor View 20 does. And some of the contrast shots were a little bit iffy as well. Otherwise, pretty good. I mean, to be fair, unless you're a really demanding user, Honor 10 is still a fantastic smartphone. You cannot fault it. And obviously considerably cheaper as well. So if money's an issue. Which would I choose, the OnePlus 6T or the Honor View 20? Already covered that earlier, but in case you missed it, Honor View 20 slightly wins it for me, mostly because the camera tech is it's more reliable across a range of conditions. OnePlus 6T would occasionally sort of oversaturate in high contrast situations, etc. And just the general, the performance is a bit of a step up for the OnePlus 6T, although that still performs really, really nicely, so no trouble there. And battery life is better on the View 20 as well. Panar, right back at you, buddy. Does it have LED notification in the top speaker? I think it does, from what I can recall. Sorry, I'm reviewing about three different phones at the moment. But yes, it does. Yeah, it's really, really subtle. So I remember this. So when it's bright lights, you cannot see it at all. But if you're like sat in the dark, then yeah, it's more obvious. I mean, can you even see that? Probably not. It's like ever so slightly flashing green at the side there. I can't. Oh yeah, you can maybe just about make it out. Yeah, so it does, but it's incredibly subtle. I didn't even realize it had one for the first few days, to be honest. How's the network speed compared with the OnePlus 6T? Networking has been absolutely fine for me. Haven't had any trouble with that. Although just now I was streaming Netflix and for some reason it wasn't doing it at full resolution. Not really sure what that was about. It's the first time maybe it's because I'm doing this live stream and my Wi-Fi is just balls. Maybe that's got something to do with it. And also the Bluetooth really good as well. I haven't had any problems with Bluetooth connectivity. Works perfectly with wireless headphones. Even in central London, I haven't had any dropouts or anything, so that's been great. How much would you rate on a scale 1 to 10 for the selfie cam? Selfie cam's good as well, 25 megapixels, so certainly more than what I need. Let's take a little selfie now. Hey guys, doing a live stream! Yay! Sorry. It's got the portrait mode, which works perfectly fine, despite the fact it's just a single lens front-facing camera. You've even got the AI mode, if you want that. It doesn't seem to do a great deal with the selfie cam, the AI mode. But it's absolutely fine. At least it can pick you out if you're shooting a picture of yourself and it switches it to portrait mode or whatever. What else have we got? Does it use light sensors? Yeah, it's got automatic brightness on there and everything as well. Charging time from 0 to 100, looking at about an hour and a quarter, hour and 20, roughly speaking, using the official charger that comes bundled with it. It does charge really fast to 50% in, I think it was just under half an hour. It was like 28, 29 minutes. So definitely if you wake up, you're like, ah, shit, almost out of battery, need to charge it quick. It's great. Just, you know, by the time you get out of the shower, you know, get yourself looking all sexy, it'll have enough battery life to last you all day, basically. All good. What do you think about the P90's triple ISP? Can it beat that 980's dual ISP? I don't know. Sony Turkey, what? Turkey is no longer sorry. Is the View 20 cheaper than the Mate 20? Yes, I believe it is. I think the Mate 20 is around £600-700. The standard Mate 20, was it £600? This one's £500, so it's sort of like equally priced for the likes of the OnePlus 6T, things like that. Screen burning, haven't any problems with screen burning either. I mean, to be honest, I've only had it a couple of weeks, so I'd sort of expect it to take a lot longer than that anyway. If it was doing screen burn after a fortnight, then screw that. V20 or 8X? Hang on, am I reading that right? Oh yeah, also V20 or the Honor 8X, sorry, it took my brain a second to catch up there. They're very different smartphones. Obviously, Honor 8X is less than half the price of the V20. Still a fantastic smartphone though. You get a lot of phone for your money there. Great, you know, in terms of the screen and everything, you want to go and get a full HD screen. The camera tech's pretty good as well. It's obviously not quite as dependable across a full range of conditions as the V20s, but it's got that night mode, which means great low light shots. Battery life is solid, again, good couple of days out of it. So if budget's a bit tighter, the Honor 8X, you know, we really can't fault it, is great. Obviously with this, you do get the much better performance thanks to that Kirin 980 chipset. But you know, like PUBG Mobile, plays fine on the Honor 8X thanks to a good bit of GPU turbo and all that, so it's all good. How secure is the face unlocking? I've done sort of standard levels of testing. I've tested it with other members of my family with photos and things like that, and TouchWood seems just as reliable as other Honor smartphones. It generally works well. The only time it refuses to unlock for me is when I'm wearing sunglasses. It's fine if I'm wearing hats, things like that. If I'm shaved for a few days, which is pretty standard these days. But yeah, sunglasses, it fools it every time. Not that it's really an issue in the UK. Price in US dollars, sorry, do not know that. You'd have to go and look it up on the Honor website or something, I guess. HiHonor.com, I guess. Screen bleed, no screen bleed, that's all been good. Good quality display, no problems at all with the screen. Selfie camera EIS. I'm not sure actually. I think it's quite sort of standard levels of digital stabilization, I think, for the selfie cam. Yeah, seems to be sort of standard levels of EIS. I don't tend to shoot videos of myself using selfie cams, to be honest. Maybe I should start doing that. If that's something that people are interested in, I can definitely start including that in the camera reviews. Definitely let me know. It looks so big. Yes, it is. It's a bit of a big boy. It's 6.4 inches. Definitely, if you've got small mitts, such as myself, well, you're kind of stuffed anyway, aren't you, to be perfectly fair, because pretty much all smartphones these days are absolutely friggin' massive. I'm really looking forward to Sony launching the XZ4 Compact, which hopefully it will do next month. Stay tuned for all that. Don't forget to poke subscribe, ding that notifications bell to be the first to see when all of that shiz goes live. What else have we got here? Is it expandable storage? I don't think this one's got expandable storage. No, I believe it's dual SIM, but I don't think it's got the expandable storage in it. But to be honest, it's got a choice of either 128 or 256 gigs of storage. This is the basic 128 gig model. I've installed a good few apps, PUBG Mobile, things like that. I've downloaded a few Spotify albums, some Netflix stuff, and I'm still nowhere near filling that. So if you shoot a lot of 4K video or something, then yeah, you might have to occasionally, you know, back stuff up or whatever, but all good. On a V20 camera or Huawei P20 camera? Huawei P20, the one thing that the P20 and the Mate 20 phones have that this doesn't is, of course, the extra lenses. So for instance, P20 Pro, the Mate 20 Pro, you got the ultra wide angle and the telephoto. Oh no, sorry, that's a lie. You don't have the ultra wide angle on the P20 Pro. So you don't have that extra flexibility, which is the one thing that I kind of missed when shooting with this thing. What was I going to say? Oh yeah. But you know, I mean, that's very much any sort of thing anyway. If you're going to be taking a lot of touristy shots, you want to take some nice sweeping vistas, things like that. It's good to have the likes of the wide angle, etc. 5G is not supported by the V20. No, that's going to be far too expensive, unfortunately. I wouldn't expect to see that anything other than a really premium smartphone anytime soon. Good night, Erdogan. Thanks for joining us. Is the hole better than the notch? That's a good question. It's much of a muchness, to be honest. It basically is a notch, just that way a bit. It's absolutely fine. I don't give a shit about notches, to be honest. I'm absolutely fine with notches. Most apps just put a line across that bit anyway, so it doesn't even come into play. It looks kind of funky, I guess, because it's something a bit different. There's so many notch ones. Every phone has a notch now. Ugh. Any good use of the TOF 3D camera? This is the other thing I forgot to mention earlier when speaking about the cameras. It does have the TOF 3D camera on there, which basically can be used, in case anyone doesn't know this, time of flight. It's an accurate measurement of distances, so it can record exactly how far you are from an object. It's used primarily for 3D modeling, The Oppo RX 17 Pro, similar sort of thing. It's got a TOF camera on it as well. It also does bugger all. But what Honor reckons is you'll be able to use it to actually play games using the camera, all this kind of stuff. It's kind of high concept stuff at the moment. I'm not sure when that's actually going to be implemented. It'll be interesting to see. What else have we got? Hello from Staffordshire. Hello, Jesse B. Good old glamorous Staffordshire. As glam as Sunderland, indeed. I was thinking about buying the new S10, but they got holes in their displays yet. Apparently the US10s do have the Infinity O display, I think they're calling it. Great name. How is the camera compared with the Note 9 and the S9, especially night pics? I haven't done a direct comparison with the Note 9 or the S9. I haven't actually got either of those smartphones to hand. But the night mode is absolutely fantastic. The only thing is, if you're shooting a cityscape, occasionally it can sort of blow out some of those lighter areas. So if you're shooting a city street with like neon signs, things like that, some of the times the neon signs can be a little bit sort of blown out. But incredible detail levels still. I definitely say that this beats the S9 and the Note 9 just for general detail levels and in low light situations. Go check out my full camera review and you'll see some photo samples and all the rest. So that's all good. What colors does it come in? So I think it's just blue and black. And I think this is the Sapphire Blue model. And you can also get it in, Phantom Blue, I think it is, which is a lighter version of it. And of course, if you just hold it up there, so you can sort of see the sexy V style design when it sort of catches the light. It's kind of hard to it's kind of hard to do this way, but yeah, no, it is quite sexy. I do quite like it, and it's not like in your face either. It's definitely some good stuff. Do you recommend the Honor 10 or the Honor Play? Is there much difference between them? Honor 10 and Honor Play, so. Honor 10, Honor Play, fairly similar in terms of specs. The Honor Play obviously came a little bit later, so did it have the night mode? I think it had the night mode. It's got all the GPU turbos, all these, the main features have then been sent to the Honor 10 in updates. So you've got the whole lot. Sorry, my brain is melting. I'm so tired. I was up crazy early this morning and I've got nothing left to give. Hello from a very cold island, lol. My commiserations. Yeah, that's always joyous. A55 or 980, well. Okay, so Snapdragon 855 or Kirin 980 in terms of the actual chipsets. Qualcomm just launched the Snapdragon 855 a couple of months after Huawei launched the Kirin 980. Qualcomm didn't name the Kirin 980 specifically, but it did say in its benchmarking tests that the 855 is superior in terms of performance, and I believe it was general efficiency as well, and performance consistency as well is the important thing. Apparently the 980, they reckons, goes through sort of peaks and troughs, whereas the Snapdragon 855 can maintain a nice smooth performance. Thanks for liking, Stormy, much appreciated. So it'll be interesting to see. I haven't actually personally used the 855 beyond on a couple of prototype test devices. So once those first devices start rolling out, the likes of the OnePlus 7, hopefully the Sony Xperia XZ4, things like that, then I'll be able to tell you which one is the winner there. But definitely go check out my full in-depth Snapdragon 855 preview. We've run through all of the great new features that it's going to include. Some of the stuff, including the in-screen fingerprint sensor stuff, looks really, really good. Hi, I like your videos, lol, thank you. I hope that's not a sarcastic comment. Hi from Essex, hello Essex. Would you recommend the Honor 10 Lite as an upgrade? Honor 10 Lite, if you're on a really strong budget, the Honor 10 Lite, it's pretty solid all around. Performance, a little bit jittery here and there, but otherwise good. Battery life is great. Camera's pretty decent, to be fair, for a budget smartphone. So it depends what you're upgrading from, I guess. If you're having issues with your phone, then it is a solid budget choice. People want the Netflix! The Netflix on this bad boy. Cool, can do a bit of that. Back on the Netflix. Unfortunately, my Wi-Fi seems to be mostly dedicating itself to this stream. So the quality of the Netflix might not be amazing. I'm just going to turn down the volume again. But here's a bit of Punisher season 2. Spoiler alerts for anyone who hasn't seen season 1 yet. Stuff might happen. I've got no control over that now. Is the honor play with the extra £20 over the 8X? So honor play versus the 8X, main thing for me is the performance, basically, in terms of most of the stuff. The battery life's great, camera tech's great, both got nice big screens and everything, both big smartphones. So yeah, so the performance, but the Honor 8X, it'll still play PUBG and, you know, it'll do all the stuff that you want it to do, basically. Can you see the screen with polarized sunglasses? Yes, you can. It's not like most of the budget smartphones where you stick on sunglasses and suddenly you can't see shit. Not great, especially if you're driving, using it as a sat-nav or something like that. But this one's been absolutely fine, touch wood. What colour would you recommend for the Honor 10 Lite? That one, I believe that came in the same sort of colours as this, like blue and black, right? So yeah, I mean, the lighter colours are, I'm always a fan of the more sort of vivid, vibrant colours. So anything that's a bit more colourful, definitely Honor nails it on that one. How are you? Oh, I'm very good, thanks for asking. I'm a bit tired, a bit sweaty, to be perfectly honest. I've been up all day working hard, producing some more lovely video content for you fine people. So hopefully I'm making sense now. Is the View 20 vulnerable to scratches? Nope. No, it's fine. You do actually get a cover in the box. I've got the box right here. So I'll just weasel that on out. If it's actually in here, I might have not put it back. I know I have. It's always good. So yeah, you do actually get a cover bundled in the box, and it is a transparent one. And if you slap it on, I'll just slap it on now. Slap it on there. Oh, I've got people messaging me. Go away. Go away. Go away. Go away. Not you fine people, obviously. As you can see there, with the transparent cover slapped on, it doesn't really add much girth or anything to it. And you can still see that sort of funky effect. Obviously, it takes some of the sexiness away because it's kind of like slapping. It's like slapping a condom on it, basically, isn't it? But it still looks right. But to be perfectly honest, I've been using this thing for a couple of weeks. I mentioned it earlier, but you might have missed it. I've been throwing it in backpacks, generally treating it with disregard. I try to sort of treat all my review smartphones with as little respect as possible, just to see if they do scratch up and scuff, because I know, obviously, everyday wear and tear and all that. And so far, touch wood, it's been absolutely fine. It's got a built-in screen protector as well, pre-installed on the front. So that seems to be doing the job too. It's got a couple of light scratches on it, but the screen obviously is absolutely fine. Brexit, yes or no? Oh, Christ. Let's not turn this into a Brexit discussion, please. Delena, hello. Hello. Honor texting, wanting their phone back. Yeah, probably, to be honest. I'd imagine it'll go back again in a week or so. They tend to be grabbing them back pretty quick. Black Shark or Honor View 20? I would say Honor View 20. I like the Black Shark. And obviously it's a dedicated gaming phone, so if you you know, you want that dedicated gaming mode and all that shenanigans, it's great stuff. You do get GPU Turbo and stuff on here, but you don't get to see it the same sort of level of dedicated gaming support as you get on the Black Shark. Don't worry, I never miss your video. Maybe you guys have something new and surprising for this year. Thumbs up, and lots of explodey things. Yeah, hopefully. there'll certainly be lots of phones. I'll tell you that much. It's friggin' January, and already I've done, what, like 3-4 reviews? I've got 2 more handsets waiting to be reviewed. It's nuts. It's crazy, people. January used to be quiet. How are you, friends? Yeah, I'm still alive, man. Still breathing. It's all good. DxO Mark, what should it be? I really like the Camera Tech. They do go off and do their own thing, the DxO guys. They shoot in like a basement in France somewhere. I just try and sort of take real life shots and stuff, and the real life shots I've taken I've been perfectly happy with. As I say, portrait modes occasionally can be a bit glitchy, but otherwise all good. Hi bro, hello, hope all is well. Is the front camera better than that of the iPhone XS? The selfie camera, it's really good, to be honest. I can't fault it. You know, as I say, 25 megapixels, you can shoot some nice crisp photos with it. The portrait mode works all right for a front facing camera, etc, etc. So yeah, it's all good. It can struggle a little bit when it comes to the sort of the high contrast stuff. So if you're trying to shoot yourself in front of like a really bright sky or something like that, it can occasionally throw it off, but otherwise all good. Love your videos from Chitty Durham. I obviously come up from that neck of the woods. Went to uni at Durham, great place, absolutely love it to bits, especially the student bars. They've probably still got street corners in Durham with bits of my old sick sort of treading into them. So, hello. And I know it gets chilly as shit up there, doesn't it? So, commiserations. I'm talking, yes, how are you, friend? It's a beautiful phone. Yeah, it really is. It is a gorgeous phone. Cannot fault it for the design work. Very slick. Better than OnePlus 6T. Personally, I think it's better in terms of the camera tech, and the battery life is longer as well. The OnePlus 6T is still a fantastic handset, though. Cannot fault it, apart from, you know, a couple of little iffy bits like the camera occasionally isn't quite perfect. So I would suggest the View 20 over the OnePlus 6T, to be perfectly honest with you. Sexy shirt, says Delena. Well, thank you. It's a bit moist, to be perfectly honest now. But yeah, I like to dress up for you gorgeous people. I'm using the OnePlus 6T. Should I upgrade to the V20? No. If you've got the OnePlus 6T, then you have no need to upgrade. Jesus Christ, you must be freaking made of money. Give me some of that money. That would be lovely. Hi, bro, says Aaron. I'm from India. I'm a big fan. Thank you very much. yes, Alper, or illustrious video editor, says hit like for the shirt. Hit subscribe for the shirt as well. If you like it, you know, it's one of my best tees. I like to treat you guys well. It isn't a budget phone, 569. No, it's definitely not a budget phone. It's a full-on flagship phone, but it is an affordable flagship. I guess you could describe it just like the OnePlus 6T. So it's not like a grand like the iPhone or anything like that. But yeah, 500 quid, it ain't cheap. What else we got? What do you recommend if you have a budget of £15 a month? £15 a month, you're probably more in the league of something like the Moto G6 stuff. Nokia 6.1, perfectly solid budget handset. I've obviously got the likes of the 8X. I think I'll probably be slightly more than 15 a month. You got like the 10 Lite, stuff like that. Huawei P Smart 2019 as well. We are just about to finish the review for that. Stay tuned for that. Does it come with a fast charger in the box? Yes, it does. Here it is. Let's just slap it back in its pack. Here you go. Got a bit of fast charge action, supercharge, as it is known. So that does the job very nicely indeed. Man, give me a way to learn English. I'm from Algeria. To be fair, I only barely speak English. I am from Sunderland, so I'm not the best person to ask for language advice. I did French for 5 years, and basically all I can say is, où est la toilette? Je suis Chris. that's pretty much it. It's piss poor. So do not ask me for that. I love fast charge action. Who doesn't? Bro, how's the display quality of the View 20 when compared with the OnePlus 6T? Both perfectly solid. I mean, to be honest, it's got to that point now where there's very little difference in terms of the display quality between smartphones. Even budget models, you know, they all come with Full HD Plus resolution now. You can generally configure the display output as well. So as per standard, go on the display, color mode and temperature. It's on vivid mode by default. You can dial that down to normal if you're just a more natural kind of visuals instead. I quite like the vivid mode because it's quite punchy. I think I've compared them both on Techspert and I've done a display comparison. You can see images on both. They look basically the same. Cannot fault it. Okay, friends, yeah. This or the Honor 10 Lite, as in the View 20 or the Honor 10 Lite? Well, they're very different prices. So I'd say if you're on a strict budget, then the Honor 10 Lite's the way to go because it's 500 quid, almost £35 a month on contract. Honor 10 Lite, still a strong phone, very strong budget offering. Honor 8X or Honor Play. So we've already covered this previously and thing, but just a quick recap on that. Honor Play, slightly better performance. So if you want something that's going to last you a bit longer, then I'd go for that one. But the Honor 8X, you know, you can still play PUBG. It's perfectly happy with everyday life, all good. You should try the Google Camera app in Honor V20. Yeah, definitely that's a good shout. I can certainly do that. Does the camera on the back stick out a lot? No, it's very, very narrow, as you can see there. So if you stick it on a table and you're using it, it's absolutely fine. There's no jitter or like shake or anything like that. All good. Do I know Algeria? I do not know Algeria. I've never been to Algeria, but I would love to. Sounds like a beautiful place. Can you expand the storage? No, it's dual SIM, but you do get 128 gigs or 256 gigs of storage. This is a 128 gig model, and like I would struggle to fill that. I mean, obviously I do swap phones quite a lot and everything, but you could download a shitload of Netflix movies, all your Spotify albums, shoot 4K footage, and then maybe after, you know, a few months or something, you'd fill it up. So it's absolutely fine. Definitely not a mid-range of €569. It isn't a budget, don't you think so? Yeah, no, it's a flagship phone. It's 100% it's a flagship phone. It's not a mid-ranger. Mid-ranger, I would say, would be more like the sort of £300 price point, that sort of £300. If I've called it a mid-ranger somewhere, I apologise, that's bollocks. Yeah, no, it's an affordable flagship. So it's a flagship phone, but not a grand, basically. Not silly money, which is always good. Thanks a lot for the answers, and I know everything to buy this beautiful phone. You're more than welcome. And as I say, we've got a full HonorView 20 review and camera review and all that stuff live at the moment as well. So go check that out if you want to know more. Any new Honor budget phones being released soon? Well, they've just released the Honor 10 Lite. And we had the 8X and everything at the end of last year as well. So I think Honor's pretty much done. At least you'd hope Honor would be pretty much done by now, because that's a lot of phones it's released. The only thing I can think of is it might release like an 8S or something like that, like a really budget, like £100 model again soon. Because it's been a while since we had the 7S and it was a bit crap. The performance was not great. Again, go check out our full review of that bad boy. Hole punch or teardrop notch? They're both basically the same. It's just one's in the middle, one's to the edge, to be honest. You kind of don't even really notice it's there. In terms of the general functionality and everything, it's not been any different from just a dewdrop notch. It's absolutely fine. Love your channel. Oh God, sorry. Oh shit. My throat is dry as out. I need to stop talking in a bit probably. But I like the view on the back. Yeah, it's very snazzy, very funky design. Honor 8X or Honor View 20. They're, you know, a completely different price point. So Honor 8X is less than half the price of the Honor View 20. Still a great phone though, to be fair. If budget is more of a consideration, this is more for the super demanding users who want that Kirin 980 performance. But the 8X is fantastic. Great full HD screen. Decent performance enough still. And battery life is fantastic and everything too. So all good. Joshua says, I'd give you 100 likes if I could. Aww. I'm getting all emotional here, guys. Any idea of pricing getting lower for this one? I wouldn't have thought for a little while, to be honest. I can't see them dropping it for a little while because it's great value for money. 500 quid, you can't go wrong. It's got like Kirin 980 in there. You know, fantastic specs all around, great camera tech and everything. Is the notification LED noticeable enough? So I briefly touched on this earlier, but basically it's a teeny tiny little... You'd basically have to turn off the light in order to notice it or stare really hard at the thing, at which point you might as well have just picked up the phone and turned it on to see if you've got any notifications. It's absolutely tiny. So I probably should have mentioned that. I completely forgot to mention that in the review. Duh. But yeah, no, it's very tiny. I didn't even notice it for the first couple of days I was reviewing the phone, to be perfectly honest. It's teeny. Hey man, what's the benefit of this broadcast? You got me, mate, to be perfectly honest. So you guys can ask me stuff and then I can just go yeah, the usual. You have a TV voice, lol, try to become an actor or something. That's great advice. You know, I'd happily take lots of money to be in the CSI Miamis or something like that. I don't think they'll do a CSI Sunderland anytime soon, unfortunately, but never mind. You can use Fortnite now, question mark. Good question. Let's see if we can download Fortnite right this instant. Fortnite. Nope, not at the moment. Not available on the Google Plays. So unless it's available via some other means that Honor hasn't actually bothered to tell us about, it's not actually there right now. But hopefully that'll be going live soon, if not. And for anyone who missed the live broadcast from Honor, it supports Fortnite at 60 frames per second, and you get some kind of funky exclusive costume or something as well. Thoughts about the Xperia XZ4? Well, obviously, it's all just rumours and leaks and bits like that at the moment, so it's all hearsay, nothing concrete. But I'm really hoping that it's going to be a nice one. I do have a soft spot for Sony stuff. I love it a bit. XZ3 was a really nice smartphone. Probably not a massive upgrade over the XZ2, apart from, of course, the gorgeous OLED screen. XZ4, I am worried it's not going to be a massive jump up as well, although it should have the Snapdragon 855 in it. It should be one of the first phones to hit the UK with that. So that would be good. Definitely be very interested to test that out. Excuse me. My throat is a little dry. Hey man, tell us about what sports phones do. Sports phones? You'll have to expand on that a bit. Like phones specifically for sport, or I don't know. I mean, I gotta admit, I'm not a particularly athletic man myself. I am a long-term user, so is it okay to buy now or wait for 5G? 5G, to be honest, the only 5G phones that are gonna come out in 2019 are gonna be fucking expensive. They're gonna be crazy premium. So the OnePlus 7, they've said they'll launch a 5G model of it, but it'll be a separate model from the standard OnePlus 7, and it'll probably cost about $1,000, I think it was, they predicted. So you'll see, you know, the likes of the S10, they're going to launch a 5G version later in 2019 as well, apparently. But again, it'll be super premium. And to be honest, 5G, it's only just rolling out now. So it kind of depends where you live, which part of the world you inhabit, and whether you're going to have a dedicated 5G service in your area. But even then, to be honest, I mean, like 4G, I find that when I'm out and about, I can stream YouTube, Netflix and everything in great quality. So how desperate are you for 5G? I don't know. Will the iPhone 11 have 5G support? Probably. You know, any excuse to charge $2,000 for a smartphone. I'm sure they'll have that in there. Samsung S10 will have more impressive display than this, maybe. It'll almost certainly be a Quad HD Plus, so it'll be a sharper resolution. But see, like, I really honestly have to put a Full HD Plus smartphone and a Quad HD Plus smartphone side by side in order to notice any difference in terms of the clarity, the detail levels. Full HD Plus is absolutely fine. You'll get a nice crisp image when you're watching Netflix, doing whatever, so it's all good. Right, I'm going to have to clock off in a bit because I've just realised I've been banging on for over half an hour now. So I better go. Opinions on the chin on this phone. It's quite a slender little bezel down below, as you can see there. Not much to it. It's got no bezels to it at all. It's crazy what they can do these days, eh, kiddies? This phone is gaming good. Yep, gaming is fantastic. That Kirin 980 chipset, I've had no troubles with performance of any games that I've tried on it. Like some PUBG. Again, that GPU turbo on there as well. It's GPU turbo 2.0 now. Absolutely fantastic. Do you like bodybuilding sport? Obviously you can tell from my awesome guns that I'm all over that, definitely. All that smartphone lifting, you know, that keeps me hench, I believe the kids say. Right, I better bugger off now anyway. One more final question. Magic UI 2.0 more featuring. Magic UI, I've done a full go over that on TechSpert again. As you said, it's basically Motion UI 9. So go check out all of that stuff. It's basically exactly the same settings. You got the digital balance in there, which was introduced in Motion UI 9. If you go into the menus, you've got all the more settings, so it's all neater and tidier, just like they launched in Emotion UI 9. It's basically Emotion UI 9, by a different name. I guess they can differentiate. And then finally, is 5G can be upgrading software or build a new phone only? You've got to have a 5G modem in there, otherwise it won't support 5G, so it has to be hardware. What's digital balance? So that's basically screen time manager. It's digital nanny, basically, which iPhone introduced with its latest round that a couple of others have introduced. This just says, hey, look, you've wasted a load of time today doing this shit. Maybe go out and, you know, look at some wildlife or read a book or something. It's quite good if you've got kids, actually, because you can get some parental controls in there. Screen time management. Say it's your kid's phone, and then you can set time limits for them and all that stuff. Right. My muscles are bigger than your muscles. Almost certainly. My three-year-old's muscles are bigger than my muscles. And that's mostly because she spends half of her day punching me in the bollocks. So that gives her a good little workout. Right. Okay, that is it, unfortunately, everyone. Thank you very much for joining us and for all the comments and everything. It's been great. Hopefully that's been useful. Apologies if I didn't get to your comment. And sort of quite a few blasting through. But cheers. Thanks very much for joining in, and any more comments? In fact, go on to last week's quickies episode if you've got any more questions and leave a comment there, and I'm going to be shooting a new quickies in a couple of days for this Friday, answering any viewer comments in there. So if you've got any burning questions, I'll try and get to them there as well. Bye, baby cakes. Bye-bye. And thanks very much. Love you guys. Bye. How do you switch this thing off?